All right, well, with all respect to Bob Smith, Karen Testerman, and Jim Rubens, the second Brown officially enters this race, he is the front runner. And according to the latest numbers, the candidate also with the best chance of beating Jeanne Shaheen in the general election.
April 2014, the WMUR Granite State scoreboard reads like this, 45-39 in favor of incumbent Senator Jeanne Shaheen. But only 3 months ago, she led Scott Brown by double digits.
So there has been some movement in this race, and there's likely to be more as voters actually start paying attention.
But if the voters aren't paying attention to a tightening Senate race, you can bet that the campaigns are, as they put their individual spin on the latest numbers.
Despite 1.5 million in negative attacks from Wall Street, Big Oil, and Republican special interests, Jeanne Shaheen is running strong because people here know her and trust her to fight for them and make a difference in their lives.
You're going to see polls all over the place between now and November. In fact, there was one out this week that had Scott up 5. But the big takeaway that I took away from that poll is Scott's closing the gap.
Favorability, though, shows much better news for Jeanne Shaheen. Although she has dipped slightly this year, she still holds a rating of plus 14%. Scott Brown, though, has some work to do. 39% see him in a negative light versus only 29% positive. But the race really begins now. And with stocked campaign war chests likely on both sides, voters won't have much choice but to pay attention soon.
By the end of the summer and certainly into the fall, there's not going to be a voter in the state that doesn't know that Scott Brown and Jeanne Shaheen are running against one another.
Of course, anything can happen, but right now, everyone else in the Republican field trails Jeanne Shaheen well into the double digits. If you'd like to have a look at those numbers as well as more from the poll, you can find all of it right now on WMUR.com. Reporting live, Josh McKelvin, WMUR News 9.